are getting sick from drinking the lead in their new water, only to have the government of Michigan tell reporters that she had, quote, spliced and diced the numbers, and that she was wrong. It's the story of the MacArthur Genius Award-winning drinking water expert from Virginia Tech who dropped everything this summer and drove 15 hours straight to Flint, Michigan, so that he could test the water himself, and who found high lead levels in Flint's new water, only to have the state dismiss him as basically a traveling huckster. It's the story of the new mayor of Flint, who took the drastic step this month of declaring a state of emergency in her city, saying the town and the kids need help, need it urgently, and if they are going to recover from what's been done to them. And it is most definitely the story of Michigan Governor Rick Snyder, who was the boss of the state-appointed emergency managers in Flint, and who was the boss of the state environmental agency that bungled and botched its way to a full-blown national crisis. The same agency that told the public, well, there's no broad problem with the water in Flint, and that everyone should just relax. The science of what went so wrong in Flint is actually easy enough to understand. Flint had been getting its water pumped from Detroit. It's about an hour's drive away. So to save money, Flint's state-appointed emergency manager decided to stop buying Great Lakes water from Detroit and instead start getting water from Flint. Then in April 2014, she made the change. Now, lots of people think that drinking water from rivers is not inherently more dangerous, but river water does tend to be and thus it tends to be more corrosive. You're supposed to treat river water so that it does not corrode the pipes, because if it corrodes the pipes, then it will cause those pipes to leach out the lead that's holding them together. People will end up drinking that lead and it will make them sick. And in the case of children in particular, it can permanently lower their IQs, contribute to emotional and behavioral problems that follow them the rest of their lives. But don't worry, you can avoid all that if you just treat the river water to prevent corrosion, and that is what the state of Michigan did not do. Governor Rick Snyder's administration let Flint make the switch without the essential safeguards. Then the Snyder administration ignored the early warning signs and let the moms and dads and babies of Flint keep on drinking that water for months. But even with Michigan newspapers and Michigan Public Radio and the Michigan chapter of the ACLU all spilling this news nonstop, it's not been clear how far Governor Snyder is willing to go to clean up from this mess his administration has made. It was enough that Rachel, on this show, addressed Governor Snyder directly. Watch this.
Governor, the water of Flint, Michigan has been poisoned. And this isn't like, let me just say here for a second. I think the resistance to this being seen as a national story is because people think of lead as being like a long-term infrastructure problem, like, things went bad in that old city that needs work. If you want to make an analogy to personal health, this is not like something finally coming due after you've had bad diet and no exercise for 20 years. This is the personal health equivalent of having been shot. This is not something that went bad over a long period of time. This is they flipped a switch to turn off one spigot last April and turn on a different spigot. And the spigot they turned on poisoned the kids. The kids of Flint, Michigan have been poisoned by a policy decision. The town has been poisoned. Under your watch, Governor, through the actions and inactions of people who report to you and the people who you appointed. The emergency manager who signed that initial order to get ready for drinking from the river, he reported directly to Governor Snyder and to no one else. The emergency manager who sold the pipeline that should have been the escape hatch, he reported directly to Governor Snyder and no one else. The agency that did not tell Flint how to do this safely and that ignored the fast rising lead levels in Flint's water and that disparaged the first the EPA whistleblower, and then the professor, and then the local doctor who all tried to help. That agency reported
he announced the resignation of the director of the environmental agency that failed to protect Flint's water. Then, the spokesperson for that agency, the one who told the public to relax about Flint's water, well, he also resigned. And it seems it's not over yet. Governor Snyder says there will be more news yet to come. In a statement posted this afternoon, the governor says, quote, changes in leadership and staff are not enough. He's directing state agencies to work with the outside scientists who have tried to help Flint, the same scientists the state disparaged just weeks ago. The governor had been telling us he sent the Michigan State Police to meet with Flint about an emergency response. Now he says he himself has called Flint's new mayor and plans to meet with her so they can talk about the ways the state could offer more assistance. And the governor himself apologized, quote, I want the Flint community to know how very sorry I am that this happened. So that's big news on this outrage of a story from Michigan. Resignations, promises of change, an apology from the governor. Big, big news. But meanwhile, the children of Flint, Michigan are poisoned. Poisoned because of choices made by city officials who were not elected by the people of Flint, but instead were installed by Governor Snyder. So we know he's sorry. We know who's resigned. What we don't know is what the governor is willing to do to fix this problem that his administration caused. Does Flint get the help it needs to make sure the pipes carrying its water are not leaching any more lead into sippy cups and baby bottles and drinking glasses? Will Governor Snyder be held personally accountable? Will there be a federal response? Will the families and children of Flint be okay? Joining us now is Congressman Dan Tilley of Flint, Michigan. Congressman, thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you.
So tell me, do you see these resignations and this apology from Governor Snyder as some sort of turning point?
Well, it's certainly an acknowledgement of responsibility, which is a step in the right direction. But whether people resign, are fired, or apologize, that all may be appropriate. But what is necessary is that the governor take action now to make sure that the effect that